Bucks. And now you got youth coming out for Minnesota again.
And yet another non-rematch.
Yeah, and you don't know what to expect here out of these guys. Danny Zilverberg has just had two matches officially, 0-2.
Well, what Zilverberg does bring is a good wrestling pedigree, and two, White scores quickly on the takedown. This kid's not bad. Right now, he's probably up a weight class. He's a Fila Junior Freestyle National Champ a couple years ago. Beat one of the Alton twins to do it. So he's had that ability from a good high school program at Wayzata, just on the outside of the Twin Cities. Actually, Jay Robinson lives in that district. So you think Jay's seen him wrestle a while. It's the Zilverberg's been on the roster. Throughout their loss, Derek St. John earlier today. Probably not ready for the starting lineup, but with Alec Ortiz being inconsistent as he is, hey, why not try the
sure.
kid?
And he does get the reverse after being taken down, so a good start. Albert White, 22-7 now. And he struggled lately with his wrestling. He hasn't been very sharp. He's ranked 16th, but at one point was as high as 7th or 8th. White to his feet and out of there. He takes a 3-2 lead. A lot of you guys that have been around wrestling will remember Larry Zilverberg. This, of course, is not Larry, but it is Danny. So 151 to go in the first, 3-2, quite the early lead. Wow, that last match, boy, that was some good stuff. I mean, great scrapping by the freshman. The veteran comes back, finds a way to win. Just a really good match.
That's yeah, you force like Jamal Parks to score. Look what he can do.
Mm-hmm.
One of those gut check type of wins.
If Parks had gone out and scored first and maybe gotten a takedown the second, that would end up about 5-3 or 5-4, just about like last time. You know, you think he would have just.
You never know with a guy like Ness.
You know, he would have probably cruised along and not taken any risks and probably would have won a 1 or 2 point match. But Ness put the pressure on him and had him in a big hole.
Yeah, Iowa leading Illinois 9-3 as they're at 57. Jackson Morse up on Derek St. John.
Oh, St. John did
that. That is St. John. Look, you can see his whole leg. It looks like he's
Oh, yeah.
It looks like he's an albino with that leg, but that's all tape. Now there's White.
Nice little snap down there. Just a little shrug or snap down, whichever you prefer. And he's up 5-2. And he's out of there. Is Zilverberg 5-3. Hate it for a guy like Derek St. John, who with the injury just hasn't been able to get back to where he could be if he was fully healthy.
Huge scramble over there, by the way. A 5-3 lead for White. We go out of bounds, 34 to go. And you know, big time stage for Zilverberg to be thrown into. Mm-hmm. Hey, guess what, kid? You're going to wrestle Iowa and Oklahoma State within 3 hours.
Nice ankle kick by White for two. Throws that up. Half there briefly, tried to turn him, didn't get it done. But 7-3 now by White. Starting to show some pretty good offense here.
Key here. Oh, he lets him out in short time. Wow. Eric Guerrero looks at the clock and goes,
what are you doing?
You should have seen the facial expression.
Yeah, look at him. He's tapping his head. Think. You don't let a guy out.
This might be the only time Guerrero is not fixing his hair either. He's saying think.
Yeah. And that's going to end it at 7-4. And White might have given away a point he didn't have to give up. I mean, Zilverberg might have gotten away anyway, but you don't know.
And Zilverberg really had a problem in his earlier round match against St. John, getting off bottom. Have a hard time getting off bottom with a guy that essentially has 1.5 legs in terms of percentage. I mean, that leg of St. John wasn't much. But he held Zilverberg down pretty much the entire second period.
He gets to his base. I'm not sure White's intent on riding, and he just releases him eventually. So 7-5.
Whoa, and there's ball a hit there by St. John.
Wow, that's big.
Morse was riding too high over there, caught on his back, and it was. Referee looked at it, and he could have come back an hour later and still called the fall. I mean, Morse was not moving. Big fall for Iowa.
So 7-5 White, going in for another one, can't get it. Zilverberg is a good counter to it. 1:22 to go in the second. Riding time not a factor, 37 seconds for White so far.
Looked like White tried to knee tap and then switch off to a double. I mean, reaches the far and goes for the far knee, pushes it through and gets your opponent off balance. 7-5, but the match really, it's not as close as the score indicates.
Mm-hmm. you know, when you look at that, one guy's had three takedowns, all of a sudden Silverberg can score, third time here, tie it, and not give up an escape, you're tied. If White still would have choice in the third, but if one guy seems to control the match, but the other guy's still right there on the scoreboard.
I think it's some of these situations.
Make,
yeah, it's so much about matchups in wrestling. We can see where, you know, you could correctly predict 9 out of 10 matches, right, and still lose your overall duel meet.
Yeah.
That's what the coaches, these little posturing they play each time, looking at matchups.
Sure.
Can we save a point here if we throw somebody out here?
Right.
Do they match up better?
White trying to get another takedown. It would be his fourth if he can clear his right arm. He, so far he's not been able to. If he could clear that arm, he'd have two. But and stalemate. Good job by Zilberberg. That's, he dodged the bullet there. 7-5 final, 20 seconds of the second period. If either man would score here, it would be big in this match. A lot of times you see a guy kind of cruise control about 10 seconds left, and the other guy doesn't cruise control. He takes a shot and scores, and it can turn a match.
Had a chance to see some of that Colorado High School State Tournament recently. You know, the kid's up 4 points with 5 seconds to go, and Coast, he gets thrown to his back, loses the match.
7-5 here after two periods. White's choice.
It's like former Gopher great Damian Hahn says, if there's time on the clock, there's time to wrestle. And that's a guy that knows a lot about that, scoring in short time, coasting.
White, good elevation, up again, trying to peel him off. Not gotten it done yet.
Nice little back trip there to bring White back down to the mat.
Was almost out of there, but Zilberberg did a good job with the trip, got him back down, has better control now. Leg thrown in on the right side. White can't clear the right leg, and until he does, he's going to have a hard time getting up. Stall warning underneath on White.
And they call White for the stall. Zach Esposito on the Oklahoma State bench is going, what's the top man's offense? Crowd here doesn't like it.
And they're probably still a little frustrated on the 49-pound match where they thought stalling should have been called the other way. Of course, they're always going to think, the home crowd always is going to think it's the other way. 103 with a stalemate call. Still 7-5 White. Now, Zilberberg could get riding time. So if he got riding time, if he rode him out and got a stall, another stall call, now White's
that's
out of there.
That's not going
to
happen anymore.
8-5, White goes right back after a leg, doesn't get it. And again, White has made a lot of shots in this match, but Zilberberg has hung in there pretty well. 43 seconds left, so unless a takedown occurs in the next few seconds, it won't be a riding point. Under 40 to go, 8-5 White, Oklahoma State 7-6 ahead of the Gophers in the duel at this point. Under 30, there's a shot.
Nice,
a nice
low
little ankle.
Ankle
pick, and he got two by Zilberberg, and we talk about going into cruise control, and there it was right there.
Luke Becker telling him
to cut
him.
White kind of dawdling along, and so it'll be 9-7 after the escape by White with 12 seconds left. Now he can take a hit with a stall because he's got a two-point lead. So let's see what Zilberberg has left.
Kenny Monday telling the fans to get behind it here.
And that'll do it. Albert White, 9-7. Oklahoma State moves into a 10-6 lead.